Okay, y'all. So I scored these two nightstands, or two of them, and I have them at workroom. So I'm sorry if you hear an echo, but the doors are closed and this is the area that I work. But they were only $15 at the thrift store. I don't know if you can see the tag on this one clearly, but yeah, they were only $15. Trust me. And I am going to chalk paint them today. And there are going to be an aged gray. I'm gonna use this Rust-Oleum chalked finish, an aged gray. So the only thing you'll need is a good brush. And then I have a flathead screwdriver to remove the hardware before painting. And then I will seal it with polycrylic. So let's get started. They're very heavy, by the way, which is why I like them. These have a little bit of water damage to the top, so I will okay, so those had a little bit of minor water damage to the top, so I went ahead and saved those. Next, you're gonna wanna remove all of your hardware, of course, because even though you can safely sand these, or rather chalk paint these, and there shouldn't be a problem with the finish, chalk paint goes on everything. Metal, wood, plastic, fabric, you name it. But I kind of like this like old world type look, this brassy or aged brassy look. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep these. And then a quick tip, just add your little screw back to the back and keep it in the same drawer. And I'll finish taking these off. Once you have removed all of your hardware, it's time to do some cleanup. I like to use the Lysol because it not only cleans, but it disinfects, which is perfect for thrifted pieces. Chalk paint will stick to anything except dirt and grease. Get it clean. Also need to mention, you are gonna wanna take off any stickers that's on the dresser part or furniture piece you're working on, and also any that are inside. And you're also gonna wanna clean inside. I always clean inside when I get the piece because that's my qualification for storing it. But just make sure you use the same, can use the same Lysol wipes to clean it out. Just leave the doors open so that it dries out. And right now I'm gonna let this piece sit for about 10-15 minutes until it's dry, and then I will go ahead and start painting. It's now time to paint. You can wear gloves with this part, but I don't like to, especially when using chalk paint, because like it literally comes right off. And as far as your brush is concerned, this is a new one, but I have other brushes that I keep and I try and maintain. But don't get crazy and start dipping your brush all the way to the hilt. You just need to do maybe a third at most. It naturally travels up if you have a natural bristle brush. But just do a third, that way you preserve your brush as long as you can. Because all of this back here would be just lost paint. So that's tip of the day. And this stuff is really thick, so, you know, work in small areas. Don't do a heavy coat, do a light coat, because you'll have to put multiples on anyway, depending on how dark your furniture piece started out. So go ahead and take your time, get some nice strokes in there, and you should eventually know how many coats you'll end up using. And then I literally paint with the drawers right in place. Because when they're closed, this is the only thing that you'll see. And with the first coat, you don't really have to worry about too much of going with the grain or in the same direction. It's with your future coats that you want to be sure that you're doing it right. Right now, you're just applying a base coat, almost like what they consider a primer. Just getting it ready so that it'll build upon itself. And you may want to get some smaller brushes, which I have those as well, and I'll show you for those little intricate, pretty parts that will require some additional detail or attention to detail. Just make sure you don't have globs anywhere. That's also not a good idea. You want a beautifully finished piece. Go ahead and put a plastic baggie in a paper or foam cup. Stick your brush inside and seal it up. That way your brush stays upright and moist so that you don't ruin it and it's ready for the next application. And now it's time to get in those small corners. So I got this Woodster kind of chippy brush and I'm going in. Natural bristles, always. Okay, y'all. After 2 coats of this polycrylic, here's how the piece turned out. And I think it looks absolutely beautiful. I initially thought I would change out those 2 top knobs with some decorative ones that I bought, but nothing seemed to work just as perfect as that aged bronze look or aged brass. So I kept it the same. It does have that pop. And if you're not aware, I didn't distress this piece, but chalk paint tends to want to naturally distress itself. So you just have to make sure you keep smooth strokes like I did. These 2 side tables were originally $15 and each. And after a quick paint job and polycrylic, 2 coats of polycrylic, 2 coats of chalk paint, and this is what I got. I think it looks great. And just a quick tip. Make sure you clean your brushes in between each application. That is the chalk paint first, and then clean it before you start using the polycrylic, so that you make sure that you preserve your brushes first of all, and then second of all to make sure that you get all of the gunk out of there before you try and apply it to something else. And then finally, this piece is going next to the bed. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Give me a thumbs up. Subscribe. More to come. Follow me on Facebook. K&M Body. And my website, www.marthabody.com. Thanks so much. Have a great day.